So let's have a round of applause for and I think that the fact that there's going to be World Championship Boxing in New York is going to inspire kids from amateurs to young pros to have something to dream forth towards. My fight happened at 7:20, I believe. As most of you know, I'm observing Drew, and the Sabbath was over at 6:50. So I got to the arena, and we got warmed up. We got wrapped up, and then gloved up, and went straight into the ring. So the first few rounds served as warm up to break the sweat. And then we got it going. Originally, after Paulie won his title, I've had many phone calls about the Battle of Brooklyn, my fight with Paulie, and it's something that I've looked forward towards, and I think that sometime in the near future, it's bound to happen, it should happen. It's a great fight for New York City, it's a great fight for boxing. I think here in New York and here in Brooklyn, it'll be more than just a boxing fight, it'll be a cultural event. And it's something that I really hope can happen sometime very soon. And I'm here with my man Danny Jacobs. We're both started in Star City Boxing Club. It's great to see Danny come back after what he's gone through for the last year, such a tremendous performance.
Superstar.
Current superstar.
Thank you, Dimitri. Any questions for Dimitri? Yes, please.
I would definitely, if a fight with Paulie does not happen, I would like for a big fight to happen. Recently, Gabriel Procera has been brought up to me, and that's another fight that I'd be interested in. He's a local prospect as well. I think he's 20-1 or something like that. That's a fight that I'd be interested in. Louis and I grew up together. We're from the same gym. Unless one of us has the title, I don't know if we'll be fighting each other.
Thank you. Yeah, we're planning on being back here in Brooklyn in January. And we'll be on a date in the next few weeks. And of course, it will be our pleasure to have Dimitri on the card again. Thank you. Now, what can I say? He's back. He is, just like when he left off, amazing performance, a great look, sensational, and I'm very happy for Danny Jacobs to be coming back here in his hometown in Brooklyn, New York, from the Park descended. Something which Danny and me spoke about from the very first fight down, that the plan was for you to be here on the card in Brooklyn. Plan was to fight for the world title. I know that Danny will be fighting here in Brooklyn for the world title. It wasn't tonight, but it will be another night. Really excited to have Danny back. I mean, he clearly is a name to be reckoned with in that division. We will be closely monitoring his process.
First of all, have to thank the man above for having a second chance to do what I love to do. Is such an honor. And it's a privilege to be at the Barclays Center. Growing up as a child, you know, Mike Tyson and looking up to all those guys, they never had an outlet like this. So for me to come and perform here at the first event, historic, and it means a lot to me. So I just wanna pretty much talk a little bit about my performance tonight. Going into the ring, I noticed you guys, I don't know if you guys noticed, but I came out the Kanye West stronger. You know, and it really symbolized everything that I went through and really taking control of everything that I want to go through, you know, taking control of my destiny and things of that nature. So it was appropriate. And when I was in there, I was a little nervous, had a little butterflies. But once I got my hands going, it was, about a minute and 30 seconds?
Yeah, exactly.
So I just pray that the guys are right. But, you know, I'm just glad to be back. I'm not calling anyone out. I'm not looking forward to fighting anyone specific. I'm just happy to be back in the ring. I'm just happy to be doing what I love to do. We're going to be moving accordingly. We're not going to step up too fast. Obviously, we want to get the rust out. I've been on for a year and a half, so We want to make sure we step up with the right opponents each time. I don't really have too much to say. I do want to thank the media, though, for all the support they've been giving me this past month. It really does my heart very well because it was a struggle to get to this point. So for you guys to recognize me and tell me that you appreciate me means a lot to me. Once again, I want to thank Oscar, Golden Boy Promotion, my manager Al Heyman, and my family for giving me support and still believing in me that I can one day become world champion. Thank you.
Thank you, Danny. Any questions for Danny Jacobs?
I think I answered a bunch of y'all questions in the media room, right? Yeah.
Well, clean cut, and a good person he is, and the life he lives, and just really all around as good as they come. We are planning on getting in touch with Nike as well to see if Liz Strong would be open to establish a relationship with Danny, because I think he would be the perfect poster child for that. And because I have no doubt he will be world champion.
Well, no, Oscar, I used to go by the Golden Child. You know what I am now? The Miracle Man. All right. Good.
Anyone else?
Richard, regarding Danny's future, you know, there was a couple years ago, you guys had like this Golden Boy East thing planned where you had Danny and Peter Quillen and a number of other guys from the East Coast. Now that these guys are hitting kind of main event status, are there, outside of Barclays Center, are there any other venues you guys have in mind to kind of put fights out on the East Coast with these guys?
Well, you know, I think what we saw tonight, the great electrifying crowd here in Brooklyn, New York, that really is our home for Golden Boy East. Bernard Hopkins is there, who has been very instrumental in building up the Golden Boy East presence here with those fighters, with the local fighters. He's been working closely with Danny Garcia as well, and you know, being a mentor to the young kids which we're signing here. So I really believe that this is our home. By the way, the attendance tonight was 11,112, which is really, yes, absolutely called for a big applause. After what, 20 or 30 years, no world championship fights here in Brooklyn, we come back and in the first event we draw that crowd. It's quite spectacular. I talked to the CEO of the Brooklyn Nets and the Barclays Center, Brett Yormark. He is very pleased. As I said, we are looking at some January dates, and then we are working on something very special, which I can't really talk about more now for February, but I can just tell you it will be a historic event. And he will be in front of a sold-out Barclays Center. So Danny Jacob, of course, coming from here, that being his hometown, we really want to make that the base. You know, we want to bring these East Coast fighters back here and really build the market here. And that's something which I think is for Danny important as well, to bring boxing back here and be a big part of bringing boxing back to Brooklyn.
Yeah.
All right, now there is another star. A star is born. We knew he could fight. We knew he had power. We knew he was sensational. And tonight, he proved all that. And then some, the new WBO middleweight champion of the world. Kick off with Peter Quillen. Here with Oscar De La Hoya, who actually won that title, that exact same title, the WBO middleweight championship of the world, and then to have another legend there, Bernard Hopkins, who won exactly that same title, the WBO middleweight championship of the world, and here now is the future and the present of the middleweight division. An amazing performance. You saw the skills. What a great fight he fought, with the patience he fought. Bernard, the all-time reigning middleweight king, I think you were impressed, right? And so, really great to see that the middleweight division is in the hands of somebody as good, as strong, with a huge future, Peter Quillen.